She was a very straightforward person. She wasn't at all serpentine or attempting to gain her objectives by stealth. To some extent, she had to do that in the Falklands War, but nonetheless, she was, even there, she was a mixture of warrior and diplomat of a very effective kind. Her view was this, and the people who worked for her, I think, would all agree with what I would say here. We used to say she kicked up and she kissed down. That is to say, the people who worked for her in humble roles, and the detectives whose roles were not at all humble, they could do nothing wrong, and she could not be more kind and helpful towards them. She was very tough with ministers and senior civil servants. She expected them to know the facts, the job. They were working for the British taxpayer, and they should demonstrate the fact to her. So she could be very, she was never, I think, rude to people, but she was very clear in demanding answers, in wanting to get the facts straight. Now people, in a sense, think of her as essentially somebody who was always saying the same thing. There is no alternative, Tina. But the fact is, she was, she had thought about this, and she realized that if leadership seems uncertain, then it won't get any followers. And I think she was more or less correct. She is now seen as one of the greatest prime ministers. If she had been a much more ambivalent and ambiguous figure, I don't think that would be true.
We discussed how important it is to keep down public spending. We have a different problem with the deficit, but we both share similar problems of how to keep down public spending so that people may be able to keep a bigger proportion of their own money in their own pockets. And I think we're at one in resisting any moves towards protectionism.